Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Aishwarya Barab. In this video, we are going to discuss about overtone, combination bands, Fermi resonance, and introduction to IR spectrum. First, we will start with the concept of overtones. Fundamental vibrational frequencies of a molecule corresponds to transition from frequency equal to zero to equal to frequency equal to one. So here you can observe from V is equal to zero to first level of energy level, if it is going to be there, that vibrational frequency is the fundamental vibrational frequency, means which the molecules are already vibrating and which will get absorbed by the molecule when the provided IR frequency is equal to this much energy difference, then only they will absorb the IR radiation and will go to the higher energy level. That is from V0 to V is equal to 1. That is the normal fundamental vibrational frequency. Overtones occur when a vibrational mode is excited from or when the molecule makes a transition from the ground state, that is V is equal to 0, to the second excited state, that is V is equal to 2, which is called the first overtone. That is when this molecule will jump from V is equal to 0 to the directly to the V is equal to 2, that is the second energy level instead of the first one. That vibrational frequency is called as overtone, where you will see the peak for that first overtone. And if the molecule get excited from V0 to directly to V is equal to 3, that is the third energy level, it will jump from the zero energy level to the third one. So it is called as second overtone. The unharmonic oscillator calculations show that the overtones are usually less than a multiple of the fundamental frequency. So overtones are generally not detected in larger molecules. So the energy level, that is this due to the unharmonic nature of the oscillations of the molecule, there what will happen, these overtones are the number is multiple of these fundamental frequencies, and also they are normally not that much strongly show the presence in the IR spectrum. These are the weak peaks, first overtone, second overtone, whatever you are going to get, but these peaks are there in the IR spectrum. So these are the overtones. Another type of bands or peaks you will observe in the IR spectrum, those are combination bands. Combination bands are observed when more than two or more fundamental vibrations are excited simultaneously. So if the two or more fundamental vibrations are excited simultaneously, you will observe that it will be an addition of two vibrational frequencies or three vibrational frequencies where these bands will be observed. But not only addition, sometimes what happens, it will be a difference band, that is the two frequencies will get subtracted from each other and you may observe the difference band also. So combination implies addition of two frequencies, but it also possible to have a difference band where the frequencies are subtracted. One more concept we are going to learn in this video is Fermi resonance. Fermi resonance results in the splitting of two vibrational bands that have nearly the same energy and symmetry in both IR and Raman spectroscopies. The two bands are usually a fundamental vibration and either an overtone or combination band. So this is the splitting occurs between the two vibrational bands, and two vibrational frequencies or two bands involved are, one will be fundamental vibration and another one will be an overtone or combination band. So conventionally it should look like this, that is the one fundamental vibrational frequency will look like the strong peak, and the overtones, as we had discussed, or combination bands will be weak in nature. So the it should represent in the IR spectrum as a weak and a strong band or peak. But what happens in the Fermi resonance, the wave functions for the two resonant vibrations mix according to the harmonic oscillator approximation, and the result is a shift in frequency and a change in intensity in the spectrum. So here, frequency and intensity of these two peaks will change, and you will observe two strong peaks instead of one weak and one strong peak. So as a result, two strong bands are observed in the spectrum instead of the expected strong and weak bands. It is not possible to determine the contribution from each vibration because of the resulting mixed wave function. So this due to Fermi resonance, instead of weak and strong bond, you will observe two strong bonds in the spectrum. So that is called as Fermi resonance. And the frequency of this fundamental vibration and overtone should be almost similar or same, then only you will observe the Fermi resonance. If the symmetry requirements are fulfilled and the energies of the two states are similar, mixing occurs and the resulting modes can be described by a linear combination of the two interacting modes. The effect of this interaction is to increase the splitting between the energy levels. The splitting will be larger if the original energy difference is small and the coupling energy is large. The mixing of the two states also equalized the intensities of the vibrations, which allows a weak overtone or a combination band to show significant intensity from the fundamental with which it has Fermi resonance with. Examples of Fermi resonance are in carbon dioxide IR spectrum, the three fundamental vibrations are there. That is first one at 1337 per centimeter, second 667 per centimeter, and the third one 2349 per centimeter. The first overtone of second frequency, that is 667, with symmetries and frequencies of 1337. So where this Fermi resonance occur, that is the fundamental band, that is peak at 1337, is exactly near to the first overtone of the frequency 667. So if we double the 667 as per overtones, that is on the second energy level, it will be 1334, which is very much near to 1337. So that's why it will show the Fermi resonance, that is there will be a presence of two peaks in this range. Another example is aldehydes. In aldehydes, where the CH bond in the CHO group interacts with the second harmonic level, that is 2 delta, derived from the fundamental frequency of the deformation vibration of the CHO group. Here, the 1400 peak will get first, or the first overtone of this 1400 peak will be near about 2800, which will be the result is a Fermi doublet with branches around 2830 and 2730. So it is nearly same range for the CH bond, whatever the absorbance will be there. So near to that, there will be another peak, that is Fermi resonance will occur, that is two peaks at the 2830 and 2730 due to this overturn of the 1400 frequency. It is useful to understand Fermi resonance because it helps assign and identify peaks within vibrational spectra, both in IR and Raman, that may not otherwise be accounted for. However, it should not be used lightly when assigning spectra. It is easy to jump to the conclusion that an unidentifiable band is the result of Fermi resonance. However, this explanation may not fully account for the inconsistency, and further characterization may be required for the system being investigated. It is important to assign spectra before doing the normal mode calculations, because doing these calculations beforehand often leads to incorrect assignments of the peaks in the spectra. Now we will see the introduction to IR spectrum, that is how IR spectrum looks like and what are the different terminologies you will come across while interpreting the IR spectrum. Each stretching and bending vibration occurs with a characteristic frequency, as the atoms and charges involved are different for different bonds. So the y-axis on IR spectrum is in units of percent transmittance. This y-axis will always be in the form of percent transmittance from 0 to 100. You can see here. So that is the y-axis for any IR spectrum. In regions where the electromagnetic field of an oscillating bond interacts with IR light of the same wavelength, transmittance is low, that is light is absorbed and you will get a peak here. So whenever the transmittance will be low and absorbance is high, you will get a peak in the IR spectrum. Here you can see the peak. In regions where no oscillating bond is interacting with IR light, transmittance nears to 100, that transmittance will be near to 100, there will not be any absorbance, so there will not be any peak. So these are the few regions, the regions where there is no IR absorbance, these will be the with maximum percent transmittance, that is near to 100. The x-axis of the IR spectrum is in units of wave numbers, which is the number of waves per centimeter in units of per centimeter. So here you can see the x-axis of the IR spectrum will always be in the form of wave numbers. That is, here you can see on the scales from the 600 to 4000 normal range of the IR spectrum is there. So this x-axis will be always in the form of wave numbers, that is in per centimeter unit. This unit is used rather than wavelength, that is microns, because wave numbers are directly proportional to the energy of transition being observed. High frequencies and high wave numbers equate to high energy is quicker to understand than short wavelengths equal to higher energy. So that terminology is a little bit confusing. So we can use the wave number for the x-axis for the better understanding, or to get the concept that is high frequencies at high wave numbers is equal to high energy. This unit is used rather than frequency, as the numbers are more real. This unit is used rather than frequency as the numbers are more real than the exponential units of frequency. So IR spectra are observed for the mid-infrared, that is 600 to 4000 per centimeter. The peaks are Gaussian distributions of the average energy of a transition. Lighter atoms will allow the oscillation to be faster, that is at higher energy. And this is especially true of bonds to hydrogen, that is CH, NH and OH. So the CH, NH and OH will be always at the higher energy, you can see. These light atoms will absorb the high energy, or the it will be absorbed at the higher frequencies, wave numbers, you can say. Stronger bonds will have higher energy oscillations, that is triple bonds, double bonds and single bonds. So in case of C double bond C also, or the CH near to C double bond C, you will observe that triple bond range is higher than the double bond and then the single bond region. As opposed to chromatography or other spectroscopic methods, the area of IR band or peak is not directly proportional to the concentration of the functional group producing the peak. The intensity of an IR band is affected by two primary factors: whether the vibration is one of stretching or bending, and second one is electronegativity difference of the atoms involved in the bond. For both effects, the greater the change in dipole moment in a given vibration or bend, the larger the peak. The greater the difference in electronegativity between the atoms involved in bonding, the larger the dipole moment. Typically, stretching will change dipole moment more than bending. That's why the stretching vibrations are at higher frequency always in the IR spectrum. Detection of different bonds. It is important to make note of peak intensities to show the effect of these factors. That is, you will observe these type of or the description in the IR interpretation. That is, strong means if S is mentioned, the peak is tall, transmittance is low, that is 0 to 35% transmittance will be there for these strong peaks. If peak is medium, that is represented by M. Peak is mid-height, that is 35 to 75% percent transmittance you will observe for these peaks. And if peak is weak, that is denoted by W, peak is short, transmittance is high, that is near about 75 to 90% will be there. And broad, also BR, it is labeled with the BR, if the Gaussian distribution is abnormally broad. So broad nature of the peaks will be shown by BR. And star, this is more for describing a bond that spans many energies. Exact transmittance values are rarely recorded.